everyone, today I'm going to show you a new and improved Shulker Box crafting system that uses 1.14 features. This is the third generation of Shulker Box crafting systems, but in principle they still work the same, so we use them to craft large amounts of, for example, iron ingots into iron blocks. So the output of your iron farm, for example, that you have in Shulker Boxes can be put into this chest here at the top, and you can press the button and the Shulker Box will be dispensed. So in this case it will be filled up with iron ingots. For the demonstration I only put a single stack in there, and as soon as you would take the items out, you would break the box and dispense a new one. But there's actually a second thing that needs to be true. The box also needs to be closed, so you don't accidentally put items back. As you can see, in that case the shulker box doesn't get broken, so it needs to be empty and it needs to be closed, then it's getting broken. Right, so next you can take your iron ingots, or you can also craft everything else into blocks. Redstone dust, slime balls into slime blocks, etc. Honey bottles into honey blocks. And yeah, you would craft this here. Then the crafted items would be put into the box on the right. And as soon as it's completely filled up and closed, then it would also break the box and dispense a new one. The empty or filled shulker boxes will be put into those chests here at the bottom. In order to explain what's great about the new system, we have to take a look at the history of shulker box crafting systems. So here we got a first generation module at the slime farm of the Cycroft server. Alright, so with this system here we sometimes had the issue that items would remain behind when quickly shift clicking them in your inventory. This wasn't very common, but sometimes yeah, just an item would stay behind in the shulker box. And the other problem was the box is broken as soon as it's emptied, so it doesn't wait until the box is broken. So the cause of most of the items staying behind was a client-server desynchronization. An advantage of this system over the second generation systems is its speed, because it doesn't take long to break the box and dispense a new one. At our Netherwood farm we have a second generation shulker box crafting system, which gets rid of the flaw that if an item would remain behind in your box it would get broken regardless. So here we basically got an end gate in the back that checks if the shulker box is empty, but also if the shulker box is closed, then breaks it. But here you can already see the downside, it's relatively slow. In order to detect if the shulker box is closed, using a really nice trick that was invented by Pala Pala. So we got an armor stand that partially sits on top of the shulker box. So if you would open the shulker box, it's lifted up and it's no longer sitting on top of the pressure plate here in the back. The downside of the system is, as we've seen, it's relatively slow and it's also a bit tedious to build, because you actually got to glitch the armor stand into blocks and you need to position it precisely, so that's a bit of a disadvantage. In order to deal with the problem of the slowness, I came up with this version here that also fixed some issues that Pala's version had, where we have two shulker boxes right next to each other, so you can alternate between sides. But of course, it's more effort to build it like this. The advantage of the new system is that it doesn't require any armor stands or other entities, and it's also a bit quicker again. The only question now is, how do we detect that the shulker box is getting closed? The answer is that we use a new behavior that was added in Minecraft 1.14. You're now able to place redstone dust or repeaters on top of shulker boxes. And additionally, you're also now able to power shulker boxes. And see, we can power the redstone lamp through the shulker box. But that's not enough, because well, how does it help to detect if you open or close it? There's one more thing. If you actually open the box, then this is no longer a block that can be powered. But as you can see, the redstone lamp is still on. The reason is no update is sent when the shulker box is getting opened. So I'm just gonna add here a little chain of repeaters, like this. Now we turn this on, open the box, and it will be updated by the repeater over here, and as you can see, it's no longer powered. But of course you can update the redstone lamp again. Could send block update by breaking the redstone dust over there, now it's getting turned on again. So now we can basically detect if the Shulker box is opened by checking if it's getting powered. Using the Shulker box behavior, we could actually make new block update detectors, but this is not really that useful because you can't automatically open a Shulker box. So you can make a block event detector with this, but unfortunately still relies on the player opening the box. Right, but for the Shulker box crafting system, this feature will come in very handy. But unfortunately, things get a bit more complicated here because we can't detect the box opening directly. So we have to go an indirect way. Also, we're kind of running out of sites if we take a look at this. So we use this redstone dust here to power both Shulker boxes. But then one side is blocked. Here we have the comparator reading out the fill level of the box. On the other side, we got the dispenser, the new boxes. On top, we got a piston breaking the box, and directly at the bottom, we got a hopper collecting the broken box. So we can, for example, replace the block here for node block to directly see if the block is getting powered. So we could take an observer output out of that. What I went with in the end was actually putting a sticky piston here with a cauldron below that is getting powered by QC, so directly here from the box. Another thing the redstone dust actually does is locking the hopper directly under the Shulker box. So we got a hopper directly below it to make sure that the broken box is always collected. If you would have it one block lower, then it could sometimes happen that the Shulker box would fly out to the side here. So that's why we got the hopper directly below. Of course, if you would now open the box, then the hopper below is also no longer powered, but since it's not getting updated, everything is fine. So it still can't suck out items out of the box. Right, so the way the system works is, as soon as you would empty the Shulker box, then the comparator would turn off and we would start an observer clock here on the right that keeps updating the sticky piston through the repeater. So we get a bit of a different angle so you can see the sticky piston. There we go. But of course, at the moment, the Shulker box is open, so it's not getting powered. And therefore, the piston is also not getting powered. But as soon as I would close the box now, the Shulker box would get powered, and then sticky piston as well gets updated by the repeater here, and then the cauldron at the bottom would get pushed down. There's also another piston here at the bottom that is extended as soon as the Shulker box or the next box is placed again, which has items in it, and that prevents the sticky piston from extending the wrong moment. So what happened without it is that we get into a loop where that observer immediately detects or triggers again because the observer clock in the back is still running. I can quickly show that. So it spends a new one, then the piston fires immediately again, it's getting updated, and we're looping here. So by placing another redstone dust here, you kind of prevent that. Okay, let's place this again. Move the redstone block, and now I can put in boxes into the dispenser. Now everything works fine. Just dispenses a new one, then we're good. The system on the right works very similar. The main difference is that here we start the observer clock as soon as the Shulker box is completely filled up. We also have to add the piston here at the bottom to prevent the sticky piston from activating the wrong moment. Because that sticky piston, when activating the wrong moment, would actually also update the hopper. And then items that are currently in the Shulker box would actually trickle into that hopper, but it's not supposed to happen. Only full boxes are supposed to go into here. As you saw, a lot of things are going on in order to make the system reliable and give it its functionality. Nevertheless, I managed to make it as compact as the previous systems. In case you want to build this Shulker box crafting system, here is the full material list. Additionally, you also need two water buckets to fill the cauldrons here. Alright, and here's how you can build this on your own. I wanted to do this tutorial in two takes. You want to start with the left part first and then the right one. Okay, let's build this over here. I'm going to start with the dispenser. Important part is that you have four blocks of space below. Then we can continue. Here this would be where your Shulker box is. It's just a placeholder block. And now we can also put the output chest on. Be right here. There's another hopper pointing into it. Alright, then we want to continue here. Block at the back. and a sticky piston below. And then we have a cauldron, which is filled with water. At the bottom, we have a normal piston that's facing upwards. All right, then here, this side, we're gonna place down a normal block and an observer facing this way. Then we place down another block at the front of this. And at the bottom, we place down another comparator and a repeater in front of that. Then it points into a normal block. And you want to get a redstone torch and attach it on this side, block above that, and another redstone torch here. All right, next we want to grab just either slab or a glass block and place a comparator on top of that. And the comparator points into a block. And here we got an observer facing this way. In front of the observer, it's a repeater that would update the sticky piston. Okay, then on top of the observer, we're gonna have a repeater on four ticks and downwards facing sticky piston in front of that. Oh, we can get it. There we go. All right, then we place down another observer here. Okay, then let's continue on this side. We're gonna need another redstone torch. Attach it at the block that the comparator is facing into. Then we go down with two blocks like this and put redstone dust on top. And on the side of this block, I'm gonna place down another torch. Then we're gonna add another sticky piston there, an observer facing this way. And here we got a normal block again. Then here on the side, we also got a normal block, redstone dust on top. Then we got a downwards facing observer. And now we want to grab a repeater, place it down, wait a little bit, and set it to two ticks. So the observer is going down again. All right, speaking of downwards facing observer, here we need another one, and one pointing this way. On top of that, two tick repeater, block. On this side, redstone dust, and another block here. On the side of this block, downwards facing sticky piston, and now we want to grab a slab and place it under the sticky piston. It needs to be a top slab. So this gives the shulker box enough space to open and close. All right, almost done. Now we just need repeater here on two ticks that would power the dispenser. In order to feed the dispenser, we can place down a hopper, and then we can place down a chest on top of that. I'll place it this way. In order to trigger the dispenser for the first box, we're just gonna attach a block here on the side and add a button. And now the rest. So next to this hopper here, we need either a slab or a glass block. Put some redstone dust on top. And here we got the redstone block above. Okay, then we're just gonna go over two blocks and place down another chest. Then the same hopper combo here below. And also a dispenser on the side. Okay, then here at the back, we need a block again. Below, downwards facing sticky piston, with the cauldron. Of course, also here we need to put in water. And then next, we need a node block. Oh, we got one in inventory. Place it right next to the sticky piston. They're gonna place the comparator on top. And it points into a block again. And here we got a repeater on four ticks once more. And then the downwards facing sticky piston. And this time, observer pointing this way. The other observer goes here. And there we have another four tick repeater in front. Okay, then we want to grab a redstone torch, place it here on the side. And now we can also add the normal piston here on this side. So then we need to grab repeater and redstone dust, place down dust, repeater, dust, and another node block right next to the piston. All right, then we can continue at the bottom. So right here, place a block and Parator on top. Then here we're gonna place down another repeater, points into block as well. And then we're gonna grab torches, add one here, block on top. And here the other torch, you're gonna add the sticky piston, and again, observer facing this way. This one also points into a block, when extended, of course. And now we need another vortex repeater right there. And observer pointing down and to the side like this. Then we can also add a dropper that can point anyway. Just needed to trigger the observer below. Here on top of the observer, we place a redstone dust block on the side. Then a downwards facing sticky piston once more. And the slab here. Okay, then we can also grab a hopper, place down another chest right there, and add the button here. I almost got it, almost made a tutorial without a mistake. Just forgot one important block. So right here next to the comparator, we need to place down a redstone block. All right, now the redstone part is done. Now you can also place down your crafting table, maybe right here in the middle. If you want, you can also put an ender chest on top. And we can also place some blocks around the whole thing so it looks a bit better. Maybe some stairs here, so we can still open the chest. And maybe also some stairs here at the top. Then we can surround this maybe with normal blocks. And stairs here, so we can still open the ender chest. This will be your floor. There we go. It looks quite good. Maybe the stairs this way. Alright, now let's actually also try it out. Of course, you need to fill up the dispenser here on the right with empty boxes. And yeah, I can also dispense the first one. Then I already prepared some orange boxes here for the left. Just gonna throw it in from the top just to test it. Dispense the first one. Okay, let's empty it. Okay, got another box. Looks good. And let's also try out the system on the right. So you can fill it up completely, take items out, put it back in, and break it once. Close it. Alright, looks good. Yeah, that's the video for today. Thanks guys for watching. Hope you found this video useful. See you in the next one. Bye bye.